Canucks, who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Cousins Redskins going up against Brady's Patriots.
All right, Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. A moment ago, the pride of Massachusetts, the Patriots, introduced to this, as always, sold-out crowd as they get set to go head-to-head with the Washington Redskins. Here on first down, under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
Second down, Cousins. Caught on the right side, Reed. Wow, evasive. Jordan Reed, the 20, 10, touchdown, Washington. Jordan Reed, 83 yards, and the Redskins have taken a first quarter lead. Charles, that was a heck of a play.
It truly was, because when he made that catch, he had to shake through some people, right? So that play, to me, a highlight film that should be accompanied by bass music, right? I mean, boom, 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 and he finds his way to the end zone. Terrific play.
And this one travels out of bounds, so unsuccessful there on the onside kick try.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
But when it comes to the running game, the New England Patriots, they're one of the few teams in the NFL that I don't think care much about balancing things out.
Last year, to your point, fifth in passing yardage, number 30 in the run game.
What they want to do each and every week is make a game plan based on their opponent, not so much their own personnel, and they try to attack that way.
Looking for Gronkowski, and he's got him complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, a 22. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about four. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Goes underneath here to White, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. They'll run it now out of the gun. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game.
And that's caught by Gronk for a Pats touchdown. Ron Gronkowski from 8 yards out. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. And a great example there, just getting the feet in a tough spot. It seems like every year these guys get better at this.
Well, I think the drills get better that they work on, training camp, off-season work, OTAs. But also a lot of these guys have dance backgrounds, ballet backgrounds, and they take that and carry it over to the football field.
And hello, he's going to be knocked backward as he'll be marked down right on the 30-yard line. I want to give a hat tip real quick, Charles, to J.J. Watt before the possession switches here. Walter Payton, NFL Man of the Year. They totaled up how much he helped raise for hurricane relief, $37 million.
Incredible. Hurricane Harvey, which really hit the Houston area in a big way, and his original goal was $200,000. So congratulations to J.J. Watt and all the people who participated. And Greg Olsen of the Panthers, Benjamin Watson of the Ravens, both tight ends, also nominated and finalists for the most prestigious award as determined by the NFL, the Walter Payton Man of the Year Award.
Yardage here back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you can see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of
through an opening, and there he goes. Touchdown, Washington. Chris Thompson, 59 yards. And the Redskins have taken the lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. They'll run it now out of the gun. And an alley to run. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking. And that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Deion Lewis, 45 yards. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. But before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards this past season in the NFL. We know Brady was the MVP, but Todd Gurley, Offensive Player of the Year.
How about that for a bounce back? Many were questioning whether he'd had a sophomore slump the season before. Didn't even get to 1,000 yards. Was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald?
Yeah. Accelerating, and off he goes. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Chris Thompson, 77 yards. And the Redskins get the quick strike touchdown. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the first quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front, because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through them for two touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet.
That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
Defense showing blitz. On first and 10, here's Brady. Throwing left side, he's got Gronk complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pickup there, 26 yards. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to work his way down to the 16. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a 1st and goal. Brady going to throw. And that's caught by Gronk for a Pats touchdown. Rob Gronkowski with his 2nd touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I don't know about you, partner, but I'm rubbing my eyes after that play. Did we just see that runner not get yardage? A big-time play by the defense. It does happen occasionally, even against the best running backs who are having big days.
And they'll send the slot in motion left. Now this time he'll look to throw. Josh Doctson's got it complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Cousins on first down. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. 23 yards on the play. And the slot man goes in motion left. Cousins now to throw on first down. Oh, nearly a disaster there on the check down. But they'll get it back.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open. And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
And they'll send the slot in motion left. A second down throw for Cousins. Being chased out left. Throw left side complete. That's Thompson. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A gain of 32 that time. They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Again, a run with Thompson. No dice this go-around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Well, with the kind of half he's had, I think we can forgive him that run, right? Not every run's going to be a big play, is it?
No, and also the blocking just wasn't there. No room to run.
Yeah, defensively, they got to find a way to build on that because he's eating them alive in the first half.
He opted to go with his scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
Cousins to throw for it on four, and he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Jamison Crowder, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Redskins are going to take the lead. And it's good. That makes it a 28-21 game. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The runner-up New England Patriots offense back onto the field. And I wanted to get your thoughts on the offense for this crew as they go into 2018. How do they stack up, Charles?
Typically, New England, pretty darn stable. One of the goals going into the offseason was to try and hold on to running back Deion Lewis. Because coupled with James White, that's a heck of a tandem. Of course, the big fella, Gronk. You know, you find him another all-pro year in 2017. And remember, before 2017 began, they picked up Brandon Cooks in a trade at wide receiver. That paid off in a big way. He had his third straight 1,000-yard season in the NFL. And then, of course, there's Danny Amendola, Chris Hogan. And they expect to get back Julian Edelman for all of 2018, coming off of a knee injury.
That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. Now a play fake here on first down. Gronkowski got it on the crossing route. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Brady's saying let's go as he'll hustle him to the line. Brady now to throw. He's got Lewis. Give him three on the play, and that is going to set up a third and one. Brady's saying let's go as he'll hustle him to the line. Instead of the running back in New England, sometimes they like to call him the passing back. So they get him the ball in different ways, don't they?
They certainly do. Think about the ones they've had in recent vintage. You talk about Kevin Faulk, Danny Woodhead, Shane Vereen. James White could have been the MVP in the Super Bowl if it wasn't for a certain quarterback that was on the field that day.
On first down, Brady dumps it off to Lewis. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with, but it's second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. It's a gain of about three, but it's going to leave him with third and still 7 yards to go. Throwing is Brady on third down.
That call makes sense.
Looking for Cooks, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Following the interception, Cousins. And Reed with it over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A nice gain of 21 yards. Now Cousins, dancing to it, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Cousins to throw it. Completes it right side to Doxson. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On third down, Cousins. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. Cousins in the offense is going to stay out there. They're going to try on fourth down. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. Trying to lay one up deep. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down. So they hit the ball before it went 10 yards. I know that's tough, but you got to stay disciplined.
It is difficult because you're so eager to go get the football. It's that type of a play, but you're exactly right. Have to have the discipline to let it go 10 first.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got some space here. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Patriot first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook. Go play action. Toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
They stay on the ground with White. And only able to muster a couple down to about the 27.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Deion Lewis, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. He's having a nice little game. Maybe already has an eye on that third touchdown.
How about what our producer, Christian McLeod, likes to say when they've scored touchdowns like this? He's put a tent up in Touchdown City.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here's the Redskins offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get it behind the line.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day, and sometimes that just happens. It is the NFL. They will make some plays against you.
Cousins to throw it this time. It's complete to Grant. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. A first down throw for Cousins. On the catch, it's Crowder. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. On first and 10, Cousins. The pass complete to Ryan Graham. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20. A nice gain of 21 yards. Zone now, Cousins. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And he returns it here to his own 18-yard line. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range, but boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
And he'll be knocked down sideways. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's some pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there. You see these nice, explosive, strong.
And nothing but daylight ahead. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. James White, 67 yards. And the Patriots have moved out in front. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking. Beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Gostkowski now out to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get them down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because
what? And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Now a second down throw for Cousins. Out to the left here to Reed. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Jordan Reed, 77 yards. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And things are getting good now. We're heating up, tied at 35. And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. And the defense definitely showing blitz here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just...
And oh, he caught it up, and the Redskins scoop it. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
On the run, it's Kelly. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
Crowder in motion here, right. They'll go again with Kelly. And an alley to run. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll keep it in the hands of Kelly. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They'll run it now out of the gun. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big 3rd down. Steps away to his left. His throw caught at about the 5. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Chris Thompson, 29 yards. And the Redskins are going to take the lead. And they will take a 7-point lead now. And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. Here's Brady. And Cooks has it over the middle. A good pickup there, a 22.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Brandon Cooks, 27 yards. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. And, partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Easy.
Again, they'll throw with Brady. And this is caught. And they've got the lead here in the 4th. They didn't want the tie. They roll the dice and they take the lead.
That felt like a tone setter, didn't it? Forget tying the ball game and feeling like we're just hanging with you. We're going to go ahead and push it to a 1-point lead, and that just changes the complexion of the whole game.
And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So sometimes you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense?
All defensive coordinators keep something in their hip pocket for these types of situations. What can we do to slow down the onslaught? But the biggest thing is make sure these guys encourage each other, pick themselves up, because right now, it's been a really tough ball game trying to stop these offenses.
Oh, it really has, especially as of late. Cousins now on 2nd down, rolling to his right. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also 3rd down.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Dante Hightower in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. Desperation time. Cousins on 4th down.